Good morning, students. I hope all you are fine. Today we are going to see a new topic from chemistry part for grade 9, matter in our surroundings. We see the overall topics now: introduction, physical nature of matter, characteristics of particles of matter, states of matter, change of states of matter, effect of temperature, effect of change of pressure, evaporation, factors affecting evaporation, plasma, Bose-Einstein condensate. First, we are going to see about an introduction of matter.
From the name of the lesson itself shows us, we are going to discuss about the various types of matter, that is, different form of physical objects from our surroundings. Like these examples such as stones, trees, food, water, air, table, bench, chair, these are all considered to be as matters because these physical objects occupy some space and some mass. Did you say the feelings such as sad, hunger, anger and all our emotions as matters? No. Actually, they doesn't occupy any space and mass.
Going to see about the definition for matter. So, what's the definition we read? Anything which occupies space and has mass is called matter. We see the pictures here, you know. We see the stone that is in a solid state. We see the water and the air molecules. So all these are occupying some space and having some mass. We call these common substances or commonly call it as matter. In the olden days, whatever ancient philosophers thought, they may classify these matters into 5 basic elements. We know it, you know, Panchabhutangal. What are the 5 basic elements are? We commonly know as air, water, sky, fire and earth. So, what they thought is all these matters are mainly made up of these 5 basic elements. So, they thought these 5 basic elements plays an active role in the forming of matter. Later, the scientists found out that these matters are mainly based on physical properties and chemical nature. Later, we are going to see about physical nature of matter. Matter is made up of particles. If you see any physical object around us, even ourselves is made up of very fine particles. These particles join together to form a matter of any state, either it is to be in a state of solid or liquid or gas. If you see any dew drops in the grass, we know it's very very small, but actually the single drop is made up of 10 power 21 number of particles. Even we cannot see those small particles with the help of powerful microscope also. These particles which make up matter are either atoms or molecules. We are going to see is characteristics of particles of matter. In that, we are going to see the first topic as particles of matter is very very small. To this, we have taken an example. If you take a pinch of potassium permanganate crystals, okay? We know that very well, the color of potassium permanganate crystal is purple. We are going to dissolve these potassium permanganate crystals in water. What happened? The color of the solution changes from colorless to pink. What I should do? I may take a 10 ml of potassium permanganate solution from the beaker I added to another 90 ml of water. What happens? Now it is to be 100 ml, you know. So the color has changes mildly from the original solution to the second one. I am going to do this for up to 10 beakers. What happens? Did you find any changes of color between the first one and the last one? The first one having a dark purple color and the last beaker what I get having a permanent pale pink color. So from this experiment, what did you observe? The color of the potassium permanganate crystals is going to get faded and faded on dilution. Why it gets faded and faded on dilution? Because the size of the particles are very, very small. It keep on dissolving in the solution and we get a permanent pale pink color of potassium permanganate. From this, what we understand, the size of the particles are very, very small. The next topic is particles of matter have space between them. For this also, we have an activity. We are usually preparing a lemonade, you know. To the lemonade, what we are adding? We are adding sugar crystals. For what we are adding these sugar crystals? For taste. Okay. So, when we are adding sugar crystals into the lemonade, what happens? It dissolves. Just like that, you take a beaker with water. To this, I am going to add sugar crystals. So, these crystals, what will happen? It goes on. Dissolve. Okay. So it goes on, keep on. I'm adding sugar into the water. The crystals started dissolving. Okay. Did you find any change in the volume of the beaker? When I'm adding first spoon, second spoon, third spoon, it keeps on adding up to 10 spoon. After adding 10 spoon also, and the water molecules dissolves the sugar crystals, but there is no change in the volume. Why? Because these water molecules having space between them. The crystals of sugar dissolves and goes and occupies the space between the water molecules and makes the volume of the water remain same. From this, what we understand? The particles of matter have space between them. Going to see is particles of matter are constantly moving. Before that, we must know what is diffusion as. The intermixing of particles on their own is called diffusion. For that, we are going to see an example. The diffusion of ink. This example shows us how these particles are constantly moving. Next example we are supposed to see is burning of incense stick. We know that when we have to keep these incense sticks in one corner, we get the smell of these incense stick in another corner. How it is possible? One, because there is a kinetic energy between the particles. These kinetic energy is being increased with increase in temperature. So, when the temperature is being increased, the kinetic energy between the particle is also is increased and it moves from one corner to the another corner with the help of diffusion. That is, intermixing of particles may take place. The next one we are going to see is Brownian movement. The movement of particles was found out by Robert Brown. That is, the zigzag movement of particles, we call it as Brownian movement. He found out by the movement of pollen grains in the water. So we call this movement as Brownian movement. Topic in the characteristics of particles of matter are particles of matter attract each other. So there is an attraction between the particles. These force of attraction between the particles, we call it as cohesion. So, this cohesion may vary for different states of matter. We know it very well. We have three states of matter. Well, we read from lower class onwards. One is to be solid state, another is to be liquid state, and another is to be gaseous state. In solid state, because the particles are tightly packed. In liquid state, we know it very well, it may flow, there is a fluidity possible. So there is a fluidity possible means what it shows, the particles are loosely arranged. Loosely arranging of particles only make us to feel the fluidity, flow of the particles. So in liquid, the force of attraction between the particles is very low. The third state of matter, we know it very well, is gaseous state. In this gaseous state, the cohesive force is very, very less and the force of attraction between the particle is very, very less. Due to this less force of attraction between the particles, the gaseous can easily flow from one place to another place and easily mix with each other. And compared to the previous states of matter, that is liquid and gas, in the gaseous state, the force of attraction between the particle is very, very less. So, the force of attraction is very less in the gaseous state. So, from this lesson, what we learn, we are learned about a matter. So, matter is anything which occupies some space and has some mass. And we see about the physical nature of matter. It shows the particles are tiny in size, that is very small in size. And we have seen the different characteristics of particles of matter. That is, first characteristic we have seen is particles are very, very small. Second characteristic we have seen is particles have space between them. Third characteristic we have seen is particles are constantly moving. And the fourth characteristic we have seen is particles of matter attract each other. I hope everyone of you understand this, and we have seen the remaining topic of states of matter.
We are discussed about the revision part for the lesson. Now we are going to see the question answers. First question, what are the conditions for something to be called as matter? So what are the conditions? What we have known, it should have some space, it occupies some mass, and it should have some intermolecular force of attraction. So these are the conditions for the something to be called as matter. Second question, name two processes which provide the best evidence for the motion of the particles in matter. We have seen the third characteristics, you know. So what's the third characteristic says? Diffusion and Brownian movement. So what is diffusion? Diffusion means intermixing of particles. And what is Brownian movement? Zigzag motion of particles. Okay. Third question is, which single term is used to describe the mixing of copper sulfate and water kept in a beaker on its own? Answer for this is, diffusion is the process of mixing of copper sulfate and water kept in a beaker on its own. Fourth question is, when sugar is dissolved in water, there is no increase in the volume. Why? So we have seen the second characteristics, the sugar molecules is dissolved in water and occupies the space. The same as the hypothesis, sugar molecules dissociate and fit into the space of water molecules. So no increase in volume of water. Fifth one is, when two or three crystals of KMnO4 an impart color to a very large volume of water, why? Answer for this is, we have seen the second characteristic, the same one. There must be a millions of tiny particles in just one crystals of KMnO4, which keep on dividing into smaller and smaller particles until the stage is reached. The particles cannot divide it further into small particles. Okay. Sixth question is, when an incense stick is lighted in one corner of your room, its fragrance spread in the whole room quickly. Why? Answer for this is, the third characteristics, the vapors of incense sticks moves rapidly in all direction due to diffusion of the vapor mixes with air and reaches to us. Seventh one is, a piece of chalk can be broken into small particles by hammering, but a piece of iron cannot be broken down into small particles by hammering. Why? Answer for this is, the force of attraction between the particles is higher in case of iron when compared to the force of attraction between the particles in chalk. We have seen these characteristics in the characteristics of particles of matter. That is, particles of matter attract each other. So, the nature of the attraction between the particles may vary based upon the nature of the particles. 8th one is, what is the scientific name of particles which make up matter? Answer for this is, atoms and molecules is the scientific name of particles which make up matter. 9th one is, name the process by which a drop of ink spreads in a beaker of water. Answer for this is, diffusion. The molecules in the drop of ink will diffuse through the entire beaker. That is, diffusion is the process of intermixing of particles on their own. So, the intermixing of particles among the water and ink has takes place here. 10th one is there any similarity in materials? Answer for this is yes. All the materials possess mass and it occupies some space. Thank you.